I've been on a roll recently of just talking about a ton of tips and tricks for your iPhones, and this time I want to talk about the top 5 things that you should never do on your iPhone. Now, whether you have an iPhone 6, an iPhone 10, or even the latest iPhone 11, or soon to be latest iPhone 12, I would highly recommend you guys never to do these specific things. Now, first of all, this is something that I tell everyone whenever I make a certain software video to never do, and that is installing a beta on your iPhone. And if you don't know what a beta is, okay, great. If you do know what a beta is or whether you don't, basically it's, you know, Apple sometimes comes out with this trial software. It's not trial, but kind of think of it that way, of their latest release. So right now, iOS 14, that is Apple's latest beta release. And that is not a software that is out for the public. This is software that's meant for developers to find problems and different things like that. Now on this device, I don't have iOS 14 installed, and that's how it should be. On a ton of my other side devices that I have on the side, I have iOS 14 installed because I can talk about it. But on your main iPhone, if you use it as a main device, you should not install iOS 14 at all, or you should not install a beta at all. So even iOS 13.7 is in a beta. I would recommend everyone not to install it. You should stick to the official releases from Apple. So how you can tell that is go into your settings app, you go down to general, then you go down to software updates. And usually if it says, you know, an official release like iOS 13.6.1 or something, you should go and update through that. You should never install a developer beta on your main device. Now, if you have a side phone, if you have like an iPhone 6S and you're just using it as like a developer thing, then that's perfectly fine. But installing it and using it on your main device, you're asking for a ton of problems. And that's probably the number one thing I would recommend everyone to never do. Do not install an iOS beta on your phone. It's just, you're just gonna ask for trouble. Now, the second thing I would recommend you guys to never do on your iPhone is to keep it in super hot conditions. Now, the same thing could be said for Android phones too, but there's two different caveats to iPhones. So first of all, either being in super cold conditions or super hot conditions can have some huge effects on your phone, whether you realize it or not. Now, if you take your phone out to the beach one day and it gets super hot and you take it back, most probably it's going to be okay. But sometimes you will actually get those little pop-ups on your phone that'll say, oh, it's too hot. You have to let your phone cool down a little bit before you use it. Or on the vice versa of that, sometimes it'll say your phone is too cold and you need to go ahead and get it warmed out a little bit. I've seen those pop-ups too. So you're gonna have to kind of gauge that. Getting your phone in those different conditions will first of all get you those pop-ups so you can't even use your phone in that time being, which is very annoying. But on top of that, the biggest problem of that is that the effect it has on your battery. Now, as you know, all iPhones have batteries in them, obviously, and every single battery on any device, whether it's a car or a phone or a tablet or a laptop, all of them have batteries that can degrade over time. That's why you get your batteries replaced. So on a device like this on your iPhone, if you get it in super hot conditions and super cold conditions, you'll see that your battery health will actually degrade quite a bit and noticeably faster than if you just kept it in normal condition. So if you know you're going to be out in on a beach for the next, you know, 3 years, then your phone's not going to do that great. But if you're just going for a day or two, who cares? But if you're constantly exposing your phone into super hot conditions, not only in terms of the weather outside, but in terms of the performance on your phone. So if you're always playing a bunch of heavy, intensive games and you're always, you know, making your phone super hot and then you're just leaving your book bag and it's getting burnt up in there, and that can have a huge effect on your battery. So if you want to maintain the best battery life, don't make your phone super hot or super cold and keep it just right as often as you can. So that's the second thing I would tell you. Now, kind of in that same vein, a lot of people might not even know this, but as you know, all iPhones have charging ports, whether you have an iPhone 3 or you have an iPhone 11. And you'll see that sometimes, you know, you have to go and buy a charger that might not be an authentic Apple charger. And Apple actually recommends you not to do that. If you use a charger that is not an authentic Apple charger, you are risking, you know, problems that could potentially be had with your iPhone. Now, I've seen a lot of conflicting stuff about this. Some people have said, okay, well, it doesn't really matter because all chargers are getting much better, but you can never be too careful. Now, what I would tell you is that if you have the opportunity and the chance, use an authentic Apple charger in your charging port. If you use those like 20 feet, you know, random chargers that you find at like a Walmart or something, those could potentially affect your iPhone more than you may know. That can actually degrade your battery faster. But on top of that, I've heard of some really crazy stories of like the chargers not even working, or sometimes, you know, a pop-up coming onto your iPhone saying, oh, this is an, you know, unpairable device or a non-authentic device, you can't use it. And that can cause a ton of problems as well. So sticking to authentic Apple chargers are probably the best way to go. So I would recommend you to never use a third-party or generic charger if you have the option to. Now this next thing goes along with the battery life as well. As you guys know, Apple put out a feature, I think it was with iOS 12, within, you know, for the battery, specifically optimized battery charging. And you'll be surprised by how many people actually turn this off. So if you go into your settings, you go into battery, then you go to battery health, you'll see that there is an option called optimized battery charging. Now, I personally had this off and I didn't even notice it, you know? So I would recommend you all to go and check this and make sure it's never turned off. You wanna make sure it's turned on. And what this does is basically, as a fast charging device, the iPhone 11 supports it, and I think the iPhone XS and 10 support it as well, maybe the iPhone 8 too, I totally forget. But basically, when you fast charge your device, it charges up fully up to that, you know, 100% usually, but with this enabled, it'll actually charge up to the first 80%, and then after that, it'll actually trickle charge up to that full 100%. Now, what this does is, you know, it actually increases the lifespan of that battery. Now, as you can see, actually, within my battery health, you can see I have 100%. Now, I let this phone die all the time. I let this phone charge for like 10% and then kill it. I treat these batteries really bad. And just by keeping it in normal weather conditions and also by having that enabled, it actually helps out the battery quite a bit. Now, I do charge it fully all the time as well. Now, iPhones are smart, so it's not going to charge over 100% or anything, but having this enabled will actually somewhat lengthen the lifespan of your phone in terms of the battery. So never turn this off. I would highly recommend keeping it on at all times. Now, this last thing I would recommend you to never do is something that I've seen a lot of people do. I used to do it myself, and that's in the example of when you're running out of storage. So as you know, sometimes, you know, you're playing a game or you're trying to download an app and then it says, oh, you know, you're running out of storage. You have to go and, you know, clear some storage in order to use your phone. Something that I've always seen people do is first of all, they delete photos, which I would recommend not to do. I'd recommend going into Google Photos, downloading that specific app. I don't even know where it's at on my phone, but downloading Google Photos and then uploading your photos there, unlimited storage, it's completely free. And then you can delete them from your phone. But another thing I always see people do is they'll literally go and just delete apps off their phone. So they'll literally go from here, they'll go, you know, oh, I like this game, but I need to, it's the biggest game, so I have to delete it from my phone or whatever. So they'll click here, they'll click rearrange apps, and then they'll just X out the app here so they can clear up that storage. Now, what I would recommend everyone to do, I recommend everyone never to do that. What I would tell them is instead of you going doing that and deleting off your memory and your saves and all that stuff within the game, is to go into your settings. You want to make your way to that front panel. You want to go down into general. You want to go down again into iPhone storage, which is right here. And once you're here, you'll see a bunch of different apps, you know, all the apps that you own. You can see how, you know, how much storage you have left too. Now, at this point, you want to find that specific app that's taking up the most amount of storage. Now, as you can see, Asphalt 9 was the one that was taking up the most amount of storage. Now, what you can do in this case is just click it. Now, you see two options. You see the delete app option and you see the offload app option. Now, in this case, I would highly recommend everyone to just click the offload app. Now, what this does is that it puts this specific app on the servers. It'll temporarily delete it from your phone. So it's basically offloaded. So it basically just offloads the app. And then at that point, you can re-download the app and gain all that data back that you had in the game to begin with. And that is a huge thing. That is so important. So you can click the delete app if you want to, and basically all your stuff is gone. But with the offload app, it's pretty much the same thing, but you're just able to re-download the app later with the exact same state, with the exact same saves and everything that you had before. So that's a big one I would recommend everyone to do. I'm so used to seeing people, and I used to do it too, like I had to delete all my apps and everything, but now you don't have to do it. You can just offload them, download that specific app, clear some storage later on, and then go ahead and re-download that app if needed. So that's really pretty much it. Those are the things I would highly recommend everyone to never do on your iPhone, and some solutions for them as well. If you guys have any other questions or anything, let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count, so mean so much if you guys could hit that. Also check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.